Hi, welcome. Now we start with our regular journey on Indian polity and governance. And I will say, in principle, this is my first lecture for Indian polity, and I'm going to discuss with you some important parts or important facts about Indian polity. So this is a sort of introduction to entire Indian political system or whatever we are going to study, and then we will enter slowly into the domain. So I'm going to tell about in Indian polity and governance mein, there's a most important topic is something which is called constitution. So constitution hota kya hai? That is something which we should know. Ye term ka meaning kya hai? What is the meaning of constitution? As I told you earlier also that whenever you want to understand any subject knowledge, you should know about the terminologies of that subject. If you want to study economy, if you want to study history, if you want to study polity, you need to know the top terminologies. And in politics, Indian polity or polity as a subject, there are certain terminologies which you should be aware, like what is constitution, what is parliament, what is executive, what is a federal, what is basic structure, what is article, what is schedules, so what is amendment. All these things are basic terminologies we should know. The most important term in Indian polity and governance is constitution. Constitution is basically the main law of land, the main authority from which everything flows. So any organ of the government, chahe tum judiciary ki baat karo, whether you talk about executive, you talk about the parliament, so everybody takes the power which is taken from the constitution. So power is taken from constitution, and there is a main law of the land. Let us now discuss about the constitution. See, I have here shown you three books or three documents or three constitution. The constitution of India, if you open it up, it's a book. You will see something written into that. Constitution of England, though it is not a written constitution, like unlike constitution of US or constitution of India, England constitution is not written constitution, but still whatever judiciary says, that becomes law in itself. So that is a constitution of England. And then similarly, constitution of United States of America. You know, India is the largest democracy and US is the oldest democracy, and there is a very high correlation in what India may we do and what is America may is going on. There is a very high correlation between the governance system in India and US, so that is what we need to understand. You know, constitution is the basic principle or the basic law or the main law of any country or nation, main law of the land. And this basically very clearly mentions what are the powers, what are the duties, what are the authorities, what government should do, what people should do, what are the rights of people, what are duties of people, what government is to do, what judiciary is all about, how elections will take place. So in this book, everything is written how the country will run. And who has written this? There is a body which is formed only once in the life of a history. Just say when you are born, to aapki janam patri likhi jati hai. You know that your horoscope is written. How many times it is written? Only once when you are born. So I will say this is sort of that thing only, how the country is going to run. So those our founding fathers have written that particular document for us and given it to us that, okay, now you run the country as per something which is written in this particular book. You have to run the country as per this. Sir, can we change what is written inside? Yes, to some extent we can change it. We can change it, which is called amendment. We means who can change it? Sir, people of India. But people of India, 130 crore people, where they will sit and change it? Not we, our representative. Who are our representative? Member of parliament. Not MLA, only MP. So MP sitting in the parliament, Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha, they can sit together and change the constitution, and that change is called amendment. But sir, whatever they decide, they can change it? No, they cannot do that, because there is a check and balance. You know, there is the beauty of our constitution. Constitution has allowed us to change itself, but without destroying the basic structure of it. I mean, the term of basic structure of constitution was coined later on in one of the case of Nanda Bharti case by judiciary, Supreme Court. But then Supreme Court is the body which takes care of that parliament when it is changing the constitution should not basically change its basic sense, whatever founding father created it. So basic theme should remain same. So sir, कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन की प्रोटेक्शन का काम कौन करता है? जुडिशरी। कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन को चेंज कौन करता है? पार्लियामेंट। और उसमें जो लिखा है उसको इंप्लीमेंट कौन करता है? सब, इंक्लूडिंग एग्जीक्यूटिव। दैट इज व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू सी। सो ओके, वी हैव नाउ दिस कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन इज अ मेन लॉ ऑफ लैंड। समबडी आस्क यू व्हाट इज कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन? सर, मेन लॉ ऑफ लैंड। एंड when constitution is written only once in the history of any country, and in our case there were the members 389 members to start with, out of which I think 292 elected members by elected members of provincial legislative assemblies, जो state की legislative assemblies आज होती हैं British India में, they were provincial legislative assemblies, उनमें से हमने कुछ members को उठाया, and some were nominated members, so they were not elected directly by people, they were indirectly elected people, they sit in the parliament, whatever is the parliament today, they were sitting there and making the basically constitution for us, constituent assembly. So this is how constituent assembly was formed and they created it. Can you read this, can you see these books, whatever books I have shown here? Holy Bible, Bhagavad Gita, then Holy Quran, Guru Granth Sahib. What are these books, you know? These are the sacred books or religious books of different religion. And you know, all the authority, all the rules, all the principles, everything in particular religion flows from these books. So we follow these books, right? Whatever is written in the Quran, if I'm Muslim, I will be following that. Whatever is written in Bible, if I'm Christian, I'm going to follow it. So, and every religion has a religious book in which everything, principle, guidelines are mentioned, and we follow that. Similarly, constitution is nothing but it is the supreme book, law book. It is not a religious book, it is a law book in which everything is written that how the country should run. And everybody means the people of the country, the people who are running the government, the people who are sitting in judiciary, the people who are sitting in the parliament, the people who are in defense forces, everybody is to follow what is written in the constitution. So country kaise chalta hai bhai? Country chalta hai constitution ke hisab se. That is the meaning of it. I'm telling you about the government, what is the meaning of the government? You know, government is the state. This state is not Tamil Nadu state or Haryana state or Uttar Pradesh state. State country ko bolte hain. State basically nation ko bolte hain. Polity mein, whenever I'm using the term state, you understand that simply means country or nation, right? Now, a state or a country has government is basically there are people and then there's a government. People only elect the government and government ko kuch role diya jata hai, kaam diya jata hai, they are to fulfill those activities. Like, you know, India is a democratic setup and people of India choose the government after every 5 years, and that government has different organs. And organs of the government are judiciary. Judiciary ka main kaam as far as the constitution is concerned is to interpret the constitution. What is written in the constitution, judiciary will interpret it. The interpretation, just now I told you that what is basic structure of the constitution, which parliament cannot change. What is basic structure of constitution, judiciary has not defined it. Whenever some case comes where parliament changes some law or amends some law and the case comes to judiciary, then judiciary decides that whether this is a basic structure or not. So basic structure hai ki nahi, uski interpretation kaun karega? Judiciary karegi. Constitution ki protection kaun karega? Who is the protector of constitution? That is also judiciary. Legislature means parliament and legislative assemblies. But constitution ko change karne ka kaam only can be done in parliament, not in state legislative assemblies. MLA cannot amend the constitution. Only MPs sitting together can amend or change the constitution. So who amends the constitution? Who basically changes the constitution? Who makes the law? Legislature makes the law. Executives are those who make the rules and policies on the basis of the laws made in constitution or in the parliament. So these are the people who are executing the rules or policies made. So executives are there who will follow the orders, who will execute the orders. So this is how three organs of the state are, and they draw their power, authority, role from the constitution. Let me show you through diagram. So constitution is the at the top as a law book, main law book. Our constituent assembly, our founding fathers have given this to us. Lekin now you follow this and now you use it. And then constitution mein, then there comes the legislative wing, executive wing, judicial wing. There are three wing. Legislative wing is a parliament. Executive wing is a council of minister, prime minister. You know, I have shown president here in executive. President is the chief executive. of the country. But president is also part of legislative assembly also. So parliament is made up of president and two houses, Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha. Somebody ask you, parliament ke constituent batao. So parliament ke constituent hai president and two houses of parliament. So president is there also. And he is the chief executive also, and chief justice of India, and then Supreme Court, High Court, District Court. This is how three organs are there. These are basically now Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesh. You know, if a country, if a entire world is a country, entire world is a state, then to run the affairs of that world, you have gods, deities, you know, like in Hindu mythology, it is said Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesh or something like that. Similarly, there are three organs, three basically parts of the body which actually will follow that, and they will run the country, something like that. This is how it goes. And similarly in US, if you see, US may also there's a constitution, and from constitution there's a legislative wing, and US Capitol is the basically parliament house of US, where parliament, like in India there's a parliament house, similarly there's a US Capitol. Presidential house, Rashtrapati Bhavan. Rashtrapati Bhavan ka yahan pe kya White House hai. And Supreme Court jaise India ka hai, yahan pe bhi Supreme Court, Federal Court hai. And then you know like India mein Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha, yahan pe Congress is the parliament. Name of the Congress, Congress is not political party in US, but Congress is the name of the basically parliament. It has two houses, House of Representatives and Senate. Senate is the upper house. Similarly, executive is president, vice president. जुडिशियल सिस्टम में सुप्रीम कोर्ट वगैरह सेम चीज आता है. सो देयर इज अ सिमिलैरिटी बिटवीन द थ्री ऑर्गन्स व्हाटएवर वी आर सेइंग. नाउ सी दिस स्लाइड. व्हाट लेजिस्लेटिव इज टू डू, लेजिस्लेटिव इज टू मेक सर लॉज, एंड पार्लियामेंट कैन बी बाइकैमरल, इट कैन बी यूनिकैमरल, टू हाउसेस और सिंगल हाउस, इट कैन बी ईदर थिंग. एग्जीक्यूटिव्स आर बेसिकली दोज हु एग्जीक्यूट द पॉलिसीज, इट कैन बी हेड ऑफ द स्टेट, हेड ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट, कैबिनेट. यू नो इन इंडिया हेड ऑफ द स्टेट, कंट्री का हेड कौन है, प्रेसिडेंट. हेड ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट कौन है, प्राइम मिनिस्टर. ही इज हेडिंग द गवर्नमेंट. काउंसिल ऑफ मिनिस्टर का हेड प्राइम मिनिस्टर, एंड रियल अथॉरिटी इज देयर विद द प्राइम मिनिस्टर. एंड द प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ इंडिया इज द हेड ऑफ द स्टेट. नाम चलता है प्रेसिडेंट साहब का, हर डिसीजन प्रेसिडेंट के नाम से होगा, बट रियल पावर गोज विद Prime Minister of India. So that is head of the state, head of the government, and cabinet, you know, is a cabinet rank minister. Cabinet is a small part of council of minister. Then obviously judicial system, it interprets the law. So who makes the law? Legislative. Who follows, yeah, administers the law? Executive. And who interprets the law? That is the basically judicial organ of the government. You know, are there any laws other than constitution? As we said, constitution is the main law of land. Constitution main law hai. So are there any other laws also in any country? Answer is yes, there are other laws also. We don't want to dump everything in constitution, otherwise to bahut bada book ban jayega yaar. To legal system mein lawyers jo cheez padhte hain, lawyers jo cheez dekh ke civil civil apne litigations karte hain, criminal laws ko follow karte hain, they are different documents for that. They are different from the constitution of India. Like Indian Penal Code, Civil Procedure Code, and then comes the Criminal Procedure Code. These are some of the codes or law books. Criminal Procedure Code, which is called CRPC, Indian Penal Code, which is called CPC, and Civil Procedure Code. So these are different codes, and they are written for different purpose. I don't think these are very important, and you should go in detail about that. I don't think so, but some knowledge of this should be there. Indian Penal Code is the criminal code, official criminal code. Okay, if you do this crime, then aapko dhara 302 ke tahat tumhe phansi ki saza di jayegi. As per 302 section 302, you will be given the capital punishment if you murder somebody. If you murder somebody, what will be the punishment? That is not mentioned in constitution. That is mentioned in your Indian Penal Code. Penalty, what penalty is to be given to you? So that is actually criminal code of India. That means what punishment can be given for particular crime. That entire thing is mentioned in criminal procedure code. And who reads that? Lawyer will basically, when they are practicing the law, then a criminal lawyer is going to read it. So if you go to criminal lawyer, you will find at his place all these books. जनरल स्टडीज के लिए व्हाट नॉलेज इज रिक्वायर्ड इज फर्स्ट लॉ कमीशन ऑफ इंडिया वाज एस्टैब्लिश्ड इन 1834 अंडर चार्टर एक्ट 1833. इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर आई टोल्ड यू दैट देयर आर सर्टेन लॉज व्हिच आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम इंडियन रेगुलेशन एक्ट 1772 टू इंडिपेंडेंस एक्ट 1947. व्हाट आर द इंपॉर्टेंट लॉज? वन ऑफ द लॉ वाज दिस चार्टर एक्ट 1833 ऑल्सो. Under Charter Act 1833, first law commission was established, and that was established under the chairmanship of Macaulay. Macaulay is a very important name there for educational reforms, for the legal reforms. So this is basically the information we should know. And after that, you know, when India got independence, then Dominion of Pakistan and India followed this basically Indian Penal Code. And you know this section 144, no people can go in gathering or something like that. These all are basically from these codes only. Let's go to Civil Procedure Code. No, this was related to criminal things and this is related to civil things. Civil things means it is not crime, like property inheritance. The property of parents should be given to daughters or son or both. That is a civil procedure. I mean, what is the civil law? What are the civil laws? That is mentioned here. So these things, small things, cannot be mentioned in Constitution of India. Like suppose if I murder somebody, what can be the punishment? It cannot be written in Constitution. That is the main law of land. Then from there, other laws should come out. And these are what we are discussing. So Civil Procedure Code is also one of them. So this civil code basically only administration of the civil things, whatever, not criminal things. Civil things means something which is not criminal things. So what are the procedure, what are the methods that should govern these, that is mentioned here. And you know, uniformity to civil procedure, what is the meaning of that is, like if it is a single country, then every citizen should be treated similarly. I mean, same kind of law should be implemented on everybody. Girls and boys should be treated similarly. So equal pay for equal work or equal inheritance, property inheritance. Like earlier there used to be Hindu inheritance laws, like we will give entire property to son, not to daughter. Now that particular things are not uniform civil code part. So you know, we talked today about uniform civil code. Do you know that the BJP government, when it came to the power, it came to the power with some kind of promises. One of the promise was to establish uniform civil code in the country. Irrespective of which religion you are or which community you are, you will be having same kind of laws will be implemented on you. And then later on we heard about triple talaq is not to be there. Like in Muslim community, if you say talaq three times, then husband can give talaq or divorce to the wife. No, that cannot be done. So this was the part of uniform civil code. That means you should have same kind of, you are to replace the personal legal laws, personal laws on the basis of your religion. Like there cannot be Hindu law, there cannot be Muslim law. There has to be a uniform civil law for the country, for all the people, irrespective of religion and all. That is called uniform civil code and it is a part of civil procedure code only. Then criminal procedure code, CRPC, you know, code of criminal procedure. This is also, I mean, mentioning in detail about how investigation is to be done and everything. You need not to go in detail of that. This is not important, other than that criminal procedure code, civil procedure code and other codes, whatever, Indian Penal Code, etc. we have mentioned. These all are the basically law books other than the Constitution of India. But yes, Constitution of India is the main law book. So let's go to creation. How we will now see how Constitution was created in India, and maybe we can compare it with some other countries also. 1776 for US is the date, which is 1947 for India. 1776 they got independence, 1947 we got independence. We got independence in 1947. Our Constitution was implemented, came into force in 1950. Our Constitution was adopted in 1949. These dates are very important, and similarity you find in US also. US got independence some another year. US Constitution was ready and accepted by some another year. It was implemented in some another year. Similar story flows. You understand? So Declaration of Independence 1776, when they declared that now US colonies are independent from Britain or something like that. British and other Europeans did not accept their actual independence, but yes, by Treaty of Paris in 1783, then they started recognizing US as a separate independent country. Now, there's a flow of US formation of constitution. 1776 से flow करना start किया, and 1788 में they ratified the constitution of India. Like 1949 में we ratified the constitution of India. So 1788 में they ratified. They got independence in this, but constitution was ratified here. Constitution of US is a supreme law of US, as it is a supreme law of any other country also. And it is 1787, it was adopted. Constitution Convention in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. It was adopted, similar to what we adopted the Constitution in 1949. Sir, is this information important? I don't think it is very important, other than when US got independence. General knowledge ke liye this information can be important. Or similarity, how it all goes. And you know, you should start comparing the things, then only concept will be formed. Like Indian Constitution and other Constitution, how the concept will be formed. Then what is preamble to the constitution? Preamble is actually the introduction. We will be discussing all these topics now in detail also. Preamble of the constitution is whenever you write a book, in the beginning of the book, there is a preface, there's a first chapter, there's an introduction, right? So preamble is something like that. And preamble of the constitution tells that what kind of country is this? Is this republican? Is this monarchical country? Is this secular country? Is this going to be based upon some religion? Or what kind of aspirations or objective it has for the people? What country they want to? Vision and mission statement of a country actually is called preamble. And who writes it? Founding father who write the constitution makes the preamble. So preamble of US and preamble of India resemble, you know. Here it is written that in US, if you find the preamble, it is written that we the people of United States, and similarly we have written we the people of India. So US preamble, we have referred this also, and then the Constitution of US. You know, Constitution of India and Constitution of US both are written constitution. Constitution of India is a very large, detailed written document, more than 400 articles. Constitution of US is very, very precise, you know, 7 articles. And changing the constitution of India is a very, very dynamic process, very frequent. More than 100 times we have amended it. US constitution amendment is very difficult. Why India's constitution is very lengthy, I will discuss later on. But let me tell you here. India may, every state is not having separate constitution. In US, every state has its own constitution also. So when every state is writing its own document separately, then the union, this federal government need not to write the constitution for all. But in our constitution, we are providing special status to Northeast states also. We are mentioning in detail about what are the powers of state legislative assemblies also, Panchayati Raj, municipalities. So that is the reason it is very, very detailed document. Now, what are the 7 articles of US? You should know. The 7 articles of US are these 7 articles, you know. This mentions very briefly what is the legislative branch, executive branch, judicial branch, how amendment is to take place, article 5. So very precisely written this constitution with 7 articles. You know, German is a country which had Weimar Republic. Weimar constitution is a German constitution. I will discuss with you later on that when we sat for writing constitution, jab humne apna constitution likha, us time pe we took the best thing from different constitution of the world. America se bhi we took, German se we took. So we took the best thing from different constitution of the world and wrote constitution for us. So Weimar constitution actually is the German constitution. After German revolution 1918, they created Weimar constitution for them. And 1919 August mein Weimar constitution was signed, and the structure of a German state was basically discussed there, and what will the rights of the people, that was also discussed. So sir, isme hame yaad kya karna hai? Weimar constitution kis basically country ka hai, that name you should write, that name you should remember. And what are the highlights of that constitution? As I told you, whenever constitution is written for any country, what kind of powers, authorities are to be given to people and all, that is mentioned in that constitution. So in Weimar constitution of German, German Reich is the republic. Republic something like India. What is the meaning of republic? I will discuss later on. Let me tell you, republic means the head of the state, just a president of India, head of the state is representative of public, you know, republic, representative of public. Head of the state in US is also president. That is also republic. Head of the state in England is queen, king. that is not representative of the people, that is basically monarch, and hence that is not republic. So head of the state is republic, that is the republic, that is the meaning of that. German Reich is also republic. German, jaise India mein president, prime minister and parliament is there. Similarly in German, there is a president, there is a chancellor, prime minister ki jagah chancellor, and parliament which is called Reichstag. So that is the name we need to understand. So ye naam yaad rakh lena, kya hai Weimar constitution, kiska hai ye, you have to remember. Chancellor is the real authority in German, that you need to know. President ka term is 7 years. In India president term is 5 years. You understand? Whatever president will do, that has to be endorsed by chancellor and or Reich, that is the Reich minister, or that is the parliament minister, right? So chancellor is the real authority in German, that is written there. Emergency provisions in India, which are mentioned under article 352 356 360, I will discuss later on. Emergency provisions which are mentioned in India, they are actually taken from German, and German mein emergency provisions are mentioned under article 48 of their constitution. So emergency part is very important. Legislative body is called Reichstag, as we discussed. Uniform civil code hona chahiye, freedom of expression hona chahiye, right to freedom of religion hona chahiye. So all these things which normally countries will mention, whatever they want to give to their people, that is also mentioned in Germany also. Now after having brief discussion about US, about England, about German, little comparative analysis, we come back to Indian constitution. What is there in Indian constitution? Little bit about that main law book, you understand. You know, father of Indian constitution, who was the head of the drafting committee of the constitution, is Bhimrao Ambedkar. He is called father of Indian constitution. And some dates, important dates which you need to know, are 26th November 1949 when constitution was adopted in India, that means ratified, that means Nehru and Rajendra Prasad and Bhimrao Ambedkar, everybody signed it, that okay, we accept it, we the people of India accept the constitution. We waited for some time, 26 January 1950 we waited, and then we implemented it after 2 months. Why? Because 26 January was historic date, because we celebrated Purna Swaraj Day on 26 January 1930, and that is the reason we wanted it, not 26 November but 26 January. That was the reason we waited for 2 more months and India became republic. So it almost took 3 years, that means I believe 12 days short of 3 years for constituent assembly to basically write it. How many sessions? 11 session. How many days? 165 days to constituent assembly over 3 year period. How many members were there? 299 members after partition, because Muslim League walked out. So 389 in the beginning, and then this was the number. It is one of the longest constitution as of now. 448 articles, 12 schedules and 100 plus amendments, and more than 25 parts of this constitution. The chief architect of Indian constitution is Bhimrao Ambedkar. Some important things which you need to rote memorize about constitution, that it was formed by constituent assembly. Obviously constituent assembly is that body, is that group of people who write the constitution for a country when the country is born. And that constituent assembly is created only once in the history of any country. And in the history of our country, constituent assembly was created in 1946 when British cabinet, three cabinet rank ministers came to India, which is called cabinet mission plan, cabinet plan. So they declared that okay, now you can write constitution for you. But demand was done long back. In fact, Mahatma Gandhi in 1922 talked about constitution. You know, there's a non-cooperation movement was in 1920. Before that, Jallianwala Bagh took place 1919. History I will discuss with you, and then you will understand. So Mahatma Gandhi decided, Mahatma Gandhi started thinking, ke, we can run our country as per our own constitution. Why British should give us constitution? In 1909, they gave us constitution. 1919, they gave us constitution. We are not happy with that. We want our own constitution. So 1922 mein Gandhi ji gave the demand that we want our own constituent assembly first time. Nehru report was the first attempt of India. This Nehru is Motilal Nehru, not Jawaharlal Nehru, but his father Motilal Nehru. He was a very distinguished lawyer. And Motilal Nehru, under the presidentship of Motilal Nehru, we created a constitution first time for us, that is called a Nehru report, though it was not accepted by British. I believe 1928 mein it was written. And constituent assembly was for the first time accepted, conceded, okay, we will give you constituent assembly. That was in August of 1940. These dates and these names you need to remember. When was the first time Indian created constitution for them? That was Nehru report, 1928. When British accepted that, okay, we will allow you to make your own constitution and you can have your constituent assembly. That was in August of 1940. But that was during World War II, 1939 to 1945. So they wanted Indian support. So half-heartedly, they only said that, okay, August offer mein, they said that we give you offer that after the war is over, you can think of this. Cabinet mission plan was in 1946 when World War was over and government in Britain had already changed. At this time, at this point of time, the Prime Minister in Britain was different, Winston Churchill. World War was going on. He was not inclined that Indians should get independence. But 1946 mein situation was different. I mean, Clement Attlee was the Prime Minister in Britain and he was pro-India, ki India ko independence de dete hain. Labour Party ke the wo, and then he decided, okay, cabinet mission plan, you go and give. Let the Brit, India and Pakistan make their own constitution and get free. So this was different. So August offer was the first time they considered, you know. Nehru report, as I was telling you, Motilal Nehru ji ki presidentship mein, and it was in 1928 it was presented. So India wanted some self-government, these things they wanted. So there were some main points at that time also, you know, we were requiring that India should be federation of some kind of basically states or something. So Nehru report, what was mentioned in Nehru report, that we will discuss in the history also. And that time in 1928, we were saying that, okay, Governor General of India can be constitutional head of India. We were not, that time in 1928, we were not asking for independence. But we were saying, okay, let Indian be involved in writing constitution for themselves. Because who was writing constitution? Britain was writing constitution. You must have heard Simon Commission. Any idea when Simon Commission visited India with all seven European member, no Indian member into that? So that he came in 1927, and Lala Lajpat Rai and all these people, they basically were protesting against the visit of Simon Commission, and Lala Lajpat Rai died, you know. So against that, you know, we never wanted that Simon Commission should write constitution for us. We will write constitution. We are quite capable. We should write constitution for us. So that was the Nehru report. The moment you start making linkages with the history, okay, Simon Commission 1927, then Nehru report 1928, then civil disobedience 1930. So the moment you make the links, everything will become clear for us. But as of now, we need to understand some certain things, and we need to raise our level of understanding slowly. Okay, what is the rote memorization part? 1934, M.N. Roy, Communist Movement of India. So who started Communist Movement of India? M.N. Roy. Now, he proposed the idea for the first time about constituent assembly, that constituent assembly should be created, you know. Then you will say, sir, Mahatma Gandhi also said in 1922, reference to constituent assembly, he only referred to. He did not motivate the entire movement, but M.N. Roy forcefully said, okay, let's create it. Then Indian National Congress demanded, these dates are not important, this is important. So, sir, what is important? Three most important things here. So M.N. Roy was the first who actually spearheaded the movement for this. 1940, British government in August offer said, okay, I accept in principle. 1946, mein cabinet mission came and they said, okay, India and Pakistan can create their own constitution. So constituent assembly, which was formed in 1946, that was formed under which law? That was under which mission? That is cabinet mission. It was formed in cabinet mission. So who was the pioneer who talked about constituent assembly in the first time? M.N. Roy. So when was the draft constitution made by Indians first time for them? Nehru report, 1928. When British considered the idea of constitution, okay, we will allow you to make constituent assembly after the war is over. August offer, 1940. So these were the three, you know, ministers, cabinet rank ministers, who visited India, that is Lawrence was there, Alexander was there. So these were the three members of basically cabinet mission who visited India that time. So first meeting of constituent assembly was in 9 December 1946. That was the first meeting. What you know today is the Parliament House. In that there was a meeting of constituent assembly. You can see Nehruji standing there. And it is the Parliament House even today. It looks like the same. So that time these approximately 300 members used to sit and debate for Indian constitution. Father of Indian constitution is Bhim Rao Ambedkar, you know, and he was the chairman of drafting committee. And he was chairman, but there were other members also of drafting committee. I don't think it is very important for you to memorize these names. But yes, there were seven members apart from chairman. Chairman plus seven members, they were drafting committee. That the committee which will draft the constitution, write the constitution and create the first draft. Something more about Bhimrao Ambedkar we should know is, he is the principal architect of constitution. He served as independent India's first law minister. Somebody asked you, who was the first law minister of India? He was Bhim Rao Ambedkar. He was against untouchability and you know, this entire Dalits, anti-Dalits movements, jitne bhi Dalits ke favor mein chalai thi movements aur Dalits ke against jo chalta tha, he was against that particular discrimination. Okay, ab 1956 mein he was so disturbed with Hinduism that he shifted over to Buddhism in mass conversions of Dalit into Buddhism. Okay, let's talk about the length of Indian constitution. One of the lengthiest constitution of the world. I told you one of the reasons why it is lengthiest constitution. More than 400 articles it has, 25 parts, 12 schedules, and 104 amendments have already taken place. Very first amendment took place the year it was basically implemented in 1950 itself. We are going to discuss in detail about important parts, important schedule, important amendments, that is what we are going to discuss. So longest constitution of the world as of now, this is something which we should know. Okay, now since we are mentioning about the longest constitution, though we will be discussing about the important parts and what are the important parts we should memorize, but still let me give you in this particular lecture some idea about which are the important parts. First part mentioned about the union and its territory, you know, then citizenship is part two, fundamental right is part three. So what is the most important part we should memorize? Fundamental rights, directive principle, state policy, and this. What is the meaning of 4A? 4A simply means that it was amended. Article 4A was put by, I think it was put by 42nd Amendment Act. Later on it was added. So it was not in the beginning, it was added later on as 4A. It was fundamental duties by 42nd Amendment Act. It was added later on. And rest are not that important. You remember these three, that fundamental rights, part three, part four is directive principle of state policy. What is the meaning of that? I will discuss later on. And the articles 12 to 35, 36 to 51, 51A. A means through amendment. So 10 fundamental duties were added. Swaran Singh committee recommended that the fundamental duty should be added, but they were added later on, 42nd Amendment Act 1976, during emergency it was added. And then that 11th duty was added when right to education was provided later on. And 11 duties as of now, fundamental duties we have. Okay, now these are other parts which are important parts, and then these some more parts, and these two parts are also important, panchayat and municipalities. So which part may panchayat and municipalities are mentioned? That is part 9 and part 9A. So again these are added later on, and you can see this part 9 and part 9A, 74th amendment and 75th amendment say we have added this. We are going to discuss that in detail later on when panchayat and municipalities were added. And the articles related to panchayat and municipality is 243. I am going to tell you in detail later on what is the most important article, what is the most important part. As of now, the approach you should keep is gradual evolution, gradual knowledge enhancing. Asta, slow, slow and steady. Not everything is to be galloped in one day. Slowly you remember. So as I told you, what you have to memorize? Okay, sir, there are some parts. How many parts are there in Indian constitution? Sir, there are 25 parts. Which are the most important? Sir, second, third, and third, fourth, and 4A. Fundamental rights, directive principle of state policies, and fundamental duties. Were fundamental duties in the beginning part of that? No, sir. It was added later on. Then panchayat and municipalities, these are the important parts. And what are the articles related to that? 243 articles is related to that. Okay, what are the other important parts? These are other important parts, but as I told you, not very, very important, except this. Now elections are, everything related to election is mentioned in article now, 15. So this election is mentioned in article 15. That is what you remember. Now other important parts are this emergency provision is very important part. That is 18th part. 18th part mentions about emergency provisions. So article 352, article 356, article 360. Three emergency provisions are very important. National emergency, 352. Financial emergency, 360. And state emergency, 356. We will discuss that about later on. Amendment to constitution is article 368. Very important article, 368. How to amend the constitution. Entire procedure is mentioned there. So this is all about some important parts. What are the various schedules? As I told you, there are 12 schedules. Sir, what are the most important schedule? So if you say me, sir, tell me one schedule from where maximum questions come. 10th schedule, that is related to basically anti-defection law. Anti-defection law. That if political party, I am a BJP MLA, suppose I want to join Congress, I cannot do that. Because if I do that, mere upar anti-defection law lag jayega. That is a 10th schedule. Okay, what is then seventh schedule? It mentioned about the powers and authorities, how they are divided into central government and state government, union list, state list, concurrent list. That is the seventh schedule. This now 11th and 12th schedules are mentioned about panchayat and municipalities. There are 12 schedules, not very difficult to memorize, but in that also, what are the most important schedules that I'm going to tell you? Most important schedules are 7th schedule, 10th schedule, and this 11th and 12th schedule. After that, okay, oath and affirmation is 3rd schedule. 1st schedule is talking about the union territories and their areas and all. You know, what is the meaning of schedule is? Basically the appendix, whatever details cannot be written in the chapter, that details I provide at the end. So that becomes the schedule. Like union government can make the laws on these subjects, state government can make the laws on these subjects. So though all those points are mentioned in the seventh schedule and the list, those lists are not mentioned in the constitution. At the end of the constitution as a table, these are mentioned. So this is how this all, what are the powers and authorities and responsibilities, power, authority, responsibility of panchayat, that detail may we have mentioned in 11th schedule at the end of the constitution. So that is the meaning of the schedules here. What are the very, very important features we have borrowed from others? You know, somebody asked you, the Indian constitution has taken maximum of its part from where? We will say 60% of Indian constitution was borrowed from Government of India Act 1935 itself. We have taken many things from British government, we have taken British constitution, we have taken many things from US constitution. Parliamentary system as of now we have, rule of law we have, cabinet system we have, that we have taken from British constitution. The entire fundamental law and judiciary and judicial review, etc., judicial system we have taken from US constitution. Government of India acts a federal scheme we have taken, and everything else we have taken from there. We will discuss that in detail. As of now, all you should know is that largest portion of constitution was Government of India Act 1935. What we have taken from US constitution, sir, judicial fundamental right, judicial system. What we have taken from British, sir, rule of law, parliamentary system, we have taken from British constitution. And in detail it will come what other things we have taken from others. Some very brief things about Constitution of India. India ka naam is Bharat and it is a union of state. In Constitution it is mentioned that India as a country is a Bharat also. It is not Hindustan, only Bharat is mentioned. Sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic. That is what defines us. It is mentioned all in preamble. I will discuss there. But this is what defines us. Republic, basically our Constitution was adopted on this date, and on this date we became republic. 26 January ko it was implemented. We got parliamentary form of government, which is a federal structure. Now what is the meaning of federal and unitary structure? I will discuss later on when it entire dedicated chapter comes there. Now head of the union, head of the state is president. As I told you, head of the state is president and head of the government is prime minister. Article 79, article 74. 79 article mentions about the parliament and it says parliament will have two houses, Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha, and president is a part of parliament. So which article mentions about parliament? Article 79. Which article mentions about prime minister and council of minister? Article 74. Real power is with prime minister. So whatever president will do, president is to ask prime minister. Article 74 mein it is mentioned. These are some of the very, very important parts of Indian constitution. That is why I'm discussing in detail. So we have already discussed it earlier. Then when we accepted it, Raj Gopalacharya became the first governor general of independent India. And Lord Mountbatten was the last governor general of India. Before independence, Lord Mountbatten and became first Governor General of India. Indian Governor General was Raj Gopalacharya. You understand? So India became a republic, and Dr. Rajendra Prasad became the first President of India in 1950. So these are some details which we have already discussed in the previous class. Let me give you some more facts about India. Longest constitution, these many articles. Constituent Assembly met first time 9 December 1946. Adopted 26 January 1949. Rajendra Prasad became the first president of India. Came into force 26 January 1950 when we became republic. Okay, there were 13 committees in Constituent Assembly, including drafting committee headed by Bhimrao Ambedkar. There were 385 members, out of which only 15 were women. Okay, so constitution was not typed, printed, but it was handwritten and calligraphed, you know, both in English and Hindi. So there is basically a library in parliament where the original copies of constitution are kept. Almost 3 years it took. Concept of liberty, equality, fraternity were taken from French, L-E-F, justice, liberty, equality, fraternity. I will discuss later on. It is called J-L-E-F. So we have taken J-L-E-F from French. So from where this concept we have taken, that is, we have taken from the French constitution. And Tipu Sultan was the very big admirer of French because of these things only. The law on which Supreme Court functions was taken from Japan. That from which country we have taken what, that I will discuss later on. This data, we have already discussed about these data. So who was the, which member and all these things. Let me see if some more information is to be added here. Okay, this is, I think, more or less we have discussed this particular part. Constitution mein preamble. Preamble tells us that who are the people, we the people of India, we have the authority and we give to ourselves on day 26th November 1949, we give this constitution to ourselves. And what is the vision, J-L-E-F? That thing is mentioned. I will cover this preamble separately in one of the lectures. That is how it is done. You know, there were some very, very important developments in the constitution. 42nd amendment, we will discuss the amendment later on, but 42nd amendment is called a mini constitution. This came in 1976. And any idea when was the first internal emergency was imposed by Indira Gandhi? It was imposed from this year to this year. Internal emergency under Article 352 of Indian Constitution. It was imposed by Indira Gandhi, and that time Prime Minister became very, very powerful. Prime Minister becomes very powerful. All powers are acquired by government. Judiciary does not become powerful. No other organ becomes powerful. Only executive, that is Prime Minister, becomes very powerful. And she changed almost everything in the Constitution. The 42nd Amendment is called basically the mini Constitution. Almost everything was changed. And even part 4A, which is fundamental duty, was added through this particular thing only this during this only. So 42nd amendment internal emergency ke time pe aaya tha, and it is called mini constitution, and it was passed in 1976, and it added three words. Preamble has been amended only once. The preamble or introduction of the constitution is amended only once so far, and three words were put into that were secular, socialist and integrity. Socialist, secular and integrity words, three words were added into the preamble by 42nd Amendment Act. And also fundamental duties by Swaran Singh Committee recommendation, fundamental duties, 10 fundamental duties were added. 11th was added later on. So what was 42nd Amendment Act? We are going to discuss that in detail. Okay, I think now we have come to a conclusion of this discussion, whatever I had with you about brief. So in this entire, I gave you some brief of what Indian constitution is all about, and what are the most important parts we are going to discuss in Constitution of India. So this was my first video and introduction to you about the Constitution of India, what is the meaning of different terminologies. Now you need to listen to this again and again, understand the basic concepts and understand the basic information. Fill the form and we will mail this document to you. Whatever document I prepared, I will forward mail to you. Just keep revising it. These are the most important information. And whenever I'm going to take next lectures, I'm going to make some kind of linkages with these things, and next things will be related to this. Fine. Thank you.